What is going on, guys? This is Shadow Dragon here, and welcome back to my Christmas special. This is part 11, guys, and last episode, we started MC Story. We just set up the house for Christmas, the party, because we're having it at our house, and Yuri is going to put brandy in the eggnog. I swear to God, Yuri doesn't stop bringing alcohol everywhere. Let's see what happens. Everyone's going to get drunk off their head, and we're, I don't know, let's just go. I don't know why I've been looking at the eggnog right now. I really want to pour some brandy in it. Please don't. She's gonna do it. No, I must exhibit self-control. I would not pour the contents of this brandy bottle to the eggnog. I would not pour the contents of this brandy bottle into the eggnog. Just place the bottle on the countertop. I'll make sure to come back for that later if I need it. I'm gonna go ask MC if he wants to read me. Went to bring such a serene atmosphere and be wasted just staying in the house. I seriously end the episode for no reason. Siori, what are you doing? Don't steal the alcohol. Don't do it. No. Sit. She's not a dog. Oh my god. Brandy, huh? Never had that before. I wonder how that would taste with eggnog. Siori, what is wrong with your face? Stop. It's all going wrong. It's all going wrong. Hey, MC, mind if I ask you where you got your cookies from?
Grocery store not too far from here.
Makes sense, they're all right, though, but you don't just get sick of store-bought stuff after a while. Did you learn enough British baking together?
Didn't think you'd care about whether or not I learned anything from that.
I don't, dummy. I just, look, do you want to help me make Christmas cupcakes or not?
That's what you wanted to ask? Why didn't you say that?
Because I didn't want you to get any weird ideas in your head.
From making cupcakes. That's it, we've known each other for more than a month now. There's no need to be so awkward about it.
MC, there you are. Would you like to join me on your porch outside? It's such a lovely day, and I think we can possibly get some reading in. Yuri, can that wait? Maybe why? Well, if you kind of just stumbled into my conversation with MC here. It's a bit rude to just show up and insert yourself like that, don't you think? I didn't mean to, I just figured, hey,
let's knock your haste here. Good old day. Nosuke, you weren't planning on having all of us eat so soon, yeah?
Well, not really, I suppose.
Why don't we all head outside for a bit to read, then we can come back inside to get the cupcakes ready.
That sounds like a wonderful idea. So that's not a beef, you really do have a brain up there.
Hey.
Well, Siori's drunk. Monica, where is Monica? Yuri and Natsuki be hanging out. Natsuki chuckles and starts walking away. It's just too easy to get you, man. You need more backbone.
I do have a backbone, thank you very much. It just only shows up when I'm talking to Siori.
Now that Natsuki's joining us, if I may, I'd like to surprise one of the gifts I got for her. I know it's first of wave, but I figured that might be a good time.
Really, now, if I may ask, what is it?
Normally I don't read much manga, but I found this one in a bookstore some time ago, and it might just be one of the most interesting pieces of media I've ever seen.
She pulls said manga out of her bag. What's it about?
15 Class for the Elite? Wait. Okay, give me a second. I have to double check something. Is it Class for the Elite? No, it's not, right? No, there's 25 students in class for the year. Okay. 15 students, each of a certain achievement, are elected to join the level school. What they don't know is that they've essentially been placed in a total hostage situation. They can never leave the building. That school is their life now. No, it's Danganronpa, isn't it? Yeah, Danganronpa. Wrong anime. I must confess, before I came out today, I just had to read something. You wanted to oversee each other's part? Apparently, according to the small band overseas, I'd have to kill to get out. Yep, that's Danganronpa. I haven't read too far beyond that, though. It's such a perfect blend to my complex fantasy preference, and Natsuki's more simplified. I'm reveling again, sorry.
You're fine, Yuri. We talked about this. Revel on as long as you want around me. I'll listen.
I know, but we really should be having Natsuki wait for us for too long.
Oh, right. That's fair. Let's go. Yuri nods, grabbing one of the gifts from Natsuki under a tree.
Can we check on Siori, please? I'm concerned. Monica's outside. Okay. Gotcha. Snowfalls get lobbed directly at MC and Yuri, and they hit their targets perfectly.
So it's a snowfall fight you want, huh? You up for one, Yuri?
Normally, I would have been taking such activities like a snowball fight, but, what the hell? Not sick, you've had this coming to you for a long time.
Yuri puts a gift down, gets the gloves on, and makes a snowball.
Natsuki, I think you're on your own for this one. Are you kidding me? Monica, you motherfucker. Oh, it's on now. You're gonna get your ass handed to you. You know what they say, revenge is a dish best served cold?
Natsuki and Yuri run off to have their snowball fight with Yuri picking up, get back up and hiding behind her back as they go. There they go. So, Monica, who do you think's winning that?
Oh,
come on, that's not fair. I was distracted.
Oh, it's fair. I love you more, MC.
Fine, you can play that game. The MC.
The MC.
I read the narrator and MC at the same time. MC picks up snub snowballs to throw at Monica. However, she's too fast. She never starts to throw every snowball thrown at her. She's too fast. I need a way to slow her down. Oh, hey, I think you just threw a bee fly into your hair.
Really?
Bro, it's literally snowing. Bees would be out. No.
Okay, that was a cheap shot. But everyone gets this one.
MC chuckles, gathering another snowboard in his hand. He won't get me to back down that easily.
This tastes nice. I need to look at what brandy is. If it makes eggnog taste better than it usually does, I might start experimenting with more often for other drinks.
Siori texts at her phone.
Let's see. What is brandy?
Siori. No.
Oh no. Oh no.
Oh my god. Meanwhile. Damn it. Why'd you have to get genetics to make you smaller than the average high schooler? It makes it so much more difficult to hear you.
That my adversary sounds like a skill issue.
Seriously, we're bringing skill issue into this.
Simply don't be bored with jeans that make you big.
Touche.
You're keeping it pretty competitive for someone who wants to complain about the height difference between us.
Yeah, okay, I got lucky once. Doesn't mean you just won't avoid the next couple hits I transitioning out. How are you so fast sometimes? It's unreal.
The first step is not having giant boobs.
I knew that was going to happen.
They slow you down.
Do you think I wanted to go up with these flights? I would trade this for your cutting board body any day of the week. I'd trade it right now if I could.
You've gotten so much better at zingers. Looks like I'm a positive influence on people after all.
I suppose you could say that. What if we take a break for a moment and have something to show you?
Alright, this better not be a trick just so you can get the jump on me.
Oh, believe me, it's not. I'm not that clever. Your guys' rap gifts should flow over that until they've have forgotten.
Are we supposed to be waiting until after we eat to open presents?
Don't worry, I've obtained permission for an MC to give you one early. I had bought this when the plans were for the free Mr. Reed, but then you pulled me with a snowball.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
Yurik is not singing the gifts and not singing tears with the wrapping paper.
What is this?
As we spent time in the literature club together, I believe we got to understand each other's styles a lot better. I figured there was no other way to show you how much I appreciate how we both grow as people by giving you a manga series that reflects both our own interests.
I see.
Do you not like it?
Hey, don't give any words in my mouth. I didn't expect you to do this for me, you know, especially after how angry we've gotten each other in the past. It's a very nice gesture. I'm glad you got this for me. I'm assuming you got a copy too, right?
Yeah, I did. Would you like to read it?
Hell yeah, I would. I mean, I don't exactly know if it's my preferred genre, but I am a little interested.
Splendid. Yuri grabs a copy of the same manga she gave Natsuki, and the two look for a place to sit down.
I'm so glad that we got a lot of snow left over this year. Sometimes it's not nice to get rid of the snow before Christmas happens. This year it didn't, though. That's great, because I get to make snow angels.
Snow angels?
Yeah. Sounds like you never made one before, so here, I'll show you.
Monica lays down on the ground, starts making snow angels. The slight confusion of MC. Why would you need to make snow angels anyway? You already are one. Well, minus the snow pot. Oh! Bro, that was smooth.
What was that?
Nothing. It was nothing.
You definitely said something.
No, you have no proof I said nothing.
You called me an angel now, just now, didn't you?
I said no such thing.
You can't hide anything from me, MC. Just be honest with yourself.
Fine. Let's just say completely hypothetically that I did call you an angel just now. Even though you have no physical proof that I did, how would you react?
Well, hypothetically, I would get up for the snow like this.
Okay, and
then I'd start walking towards you like this.
Okay, and
I'd tell you. Thanks for the compliment.
The translator Monica on MC quickly follows you backs away.
You look so cute when you're flustered.
Hey, stop teasing me.
I can't help it. It's too much fun.
I can handle Natsuki doing it, but you also doing this too much. Speaking of Natsuki, why don't you run off with two of Yuri? We're planning on reading for the important snowball fire.
They should be too far away from us. When I get found, there are more snowballs.
Yup.
Don't go to tell me twice. You scared, I'll shoot.
Alright. The two of them head off to find Natsuki and Yuri.
Poor Siori. Oh man, there's no telling when the brandy eggnog combo is truly gonna set in. Had never had an alcoholic beverage before, so I don't know what my tolerance is. I should really just sit down somewhere and hope the effect aftermath is mild. And yeah, I don't think I am. In fact, I had this rising urge to drink more.
Oh no. Siori pours more brandy into the eggnog that's definitely higher during his brandy bottle.
Yes.
Bro, this is gonna go so wrong. Some more time later.
What
What is this story?
Natsuki's almost finished making cupcakes in the kitchen. That's not Monica's voice. Natsuki's almost finished making cupcakes in the kitchen. Yuri's over there as well to his sister. And she and Monica watch the TV.
I've got a better idea. Why not join the repairment club and get one of the clubbers to fix it? You know why? Because when I got an interest, a club specialized in, I go to that club to join that club. Hey, Monica, have you seen Siori recently? I haven't seen her in a while. If there was anyone I would assume be off doing their own thing right now, it'd be Yuri.
I have absolutely no idea. Have you checked upstairs? Can we just be taking a nap? If she's naked in my bed or something.
True. I'll be back.
Hello, Siori. Are you doing alright? We haven't seen you in a bit.
Siori?
I'm in the bathroom. Tell me when it's cupcake time.
Alright. Are you doing okay? Do you need to lay down?
No, I'm fine. Go back to the others.
Okay.
You're right. She was upstairs. Good. I thought she had left us hanging for a moment.
Seriously, Monica? Seriously?
What?
Nothing, I just didn't really know what to say after that, you know. Like, you can't have a phrase like those.
Hmm, that is not a phrase, isn't it? Guys, cupcakes are done. Nice, MC, let's hear you meet us down here.
Already plans on it.
Good, see you in the kitchen then.
Monica walks it to the kitchen while MC takes out his phone. Oh no. Hey, cupcakes are ready.
Thanks for telling me. Be down in a moment.
Everything's going wrong. Nice, Yuri seems to be doing better now. I don't know what it was. Back when I was talking to her upstairs, she sounded sluggish. It's not Yuri's fault. Alright, it's almost time for some Christmas cupcakes.
Yuri's coming down soon, right?
Yeah, just texted her. Seems like she's almost done with whatever business she needs to attend to in the bathroom. And since it's out of the time when Monica and Natsuki are already been there, Yuri's frantically looking for something.
Where is it? I could have sworn I left it here.
Left what?
Well, Monica, you're not going to like me saying this, but hear me out. I may have brought some brandy to the party, but it wasn't my first. It was my personal bottle. I didn't plan on asking any of you to drink from it, I swear.
I figured you would have done something like that. Since it's the holidays, you said that the bottle specifically for you. I won't recommend it you for it too hard. However, I will once again remind you that underage drinking is very, very dangerous and something I do not condone. Yeah, funny how that works, because, like, the Doki's canon age is 18, but, like, American age for drinking is 21, while in Australia it's 18. So, when people are like, that's underage drinking, it just feels so weird because I can technically drink at 18 in my country.
I know. The thing is, I recall leaving unattended the kitchen on the countertop so I can potentially come back to it later. Next thing I know, the bottle's gone.
But I'm just going to tell you right now, I had nothing to do with that.
Oh, Natsuki, you know, that only makes you sound like you did do exactly that, right?
I swear I didn't do anything. You know that. I've seen the eggnog up close. Looks a little tampered with.
How so?
I believe so. I may have stirred Yuri's brandy with the eggnog. I couldn't have done it since I've only been in the kitchen one at a time today, and that was under Natsuki's request to put eggies under the tree.
I haven't been in the kitchen much either, so it couldn't have been me. I highly doubt Yuri did it. She wouldn't touch alcohol with a 10-foot pole.
Oh, by a process of elimination, I mean it was only Yuri Natsuki that did it. Yuri said that the brandy bottle was for personal reasons, so unless she's lying, there's no way she spiked the eggnog. Natsuki gets very playful behavior, so it does seem like something she would have done as a prank.
It had to be Natsuki!
That makes no sense. Firstly, it seems a little suspicious to me that everyone else quickly decides that's something I would do. None of your evidence automatically means it was me. It's mostly circumstantial. Secondly, how do we know it's actually MC?
Now you're deflecting blame, why?
Deflecting blame? Yuri, seriously, think about it. I haven't seen the eggnog since I poured the bowl for it today. For all we know, the eggnog might have been spiked since the beginning, and your brandy has nothing to do with any of this.
Look, Natsuki, you seem like the most realistic person who could have done it, so if you did, could you just say that?
Oh, look at him go down. So he's actually trying to deflect the blame. Is he going to get caught out on it? Probably not. It seems like you guys are just trying to get off me for no reason other than because you can. To be fair, Natsuki does have a point. My original deduction was just an assumption of what may have happened. But I take into consideration every possibility here. Yuri, have you stopped to consider that you might have misplaced your bottle entirely?
I guess I could have. I mean, I remember putting it on the countertop, but it has been a while. I haven't checked my bag yet, so maybe it's back in there. Allow me to check.
And if it's back in there, that means that MC did it like I thought.
What? Guys, I never do something so underhanded like this. The social climate. Do you know how bad that looked for me? I'm the only guy that's funny, and I'm the host. Stuff like that would sink my reputation all the way in high school. I may be dead sometimes, but I'm outright stupid.
That's perfectly fair. This doesn't mean I...
The hell was that? It sounded like it came from the living room. The four of them got messed up. That noise was the sensei taking the Bluey. Alright, what happens? Damn it, my tree fell over again. And Siori knocked it over. See, so he helps get Siori to stay in position. The glass cup down. That's cool. Easy does it. You're doing alright.
Hey, friends. How you doing, my bestest buddy in the whole world?
Oh, no.
MC, I'm perfectly okay. 1,000% okay. This reminds me of the time we went to the amusement park. You know the one. The one that had that really cool ride that makes you go, whenever you go on there. And he had the funny lifty loop. I love the lifty loop. You do the lifty loop and pull you and pull and your shoes are feeling good. Hey MC, speaking of shoes, have you ever heard of an aglet? I'm scared.
She drank the eggnog.
What?
She drank the eggnog.
Oh my
effort. I have had to do a lot of serious crap, but drunk Siori, that is something I was never prepared for.
Her face. Man, this, ladies and gentlemen, is why that's factory to the party.
I swear, this isn't my fault. Crap, what are we going to do with you, Siori? And she starts passing around the room in a manner similar to how I did yesterday, trying to contain how worried he is and failing miserably.
Wait a moment, Natsuki, you said you were the one that poured the eggnog in the bowl, correct? But yeah, what does that have to do with the situation? Oh, no, you're not blaming me for this crap. Okay, everyone, let's just calm down and... No, screw that. Siori's drunk and you just jumped back to Hanami since it's all premeditated.
It wasn't, I was just trying to connect some dots here. If anything, what you're doing seems more premeditated.
The Mycogonia is the powerhouse of the ribcage. Guys, what may or may not have happened doesn't matter now. We have to figure out how to get Siori from... Oh, Mr. Plug, how you doing today?
What? Siori, no, where are you going?
Mr. Plug, would you like some nutrients? I got them for you right here.
Is she looking at a plug next to your electric box? Yeah, it seems so.
You would like these nutrients, gay?
Oh, crap. She's going to pull the eggnog onto the wire. We need to stop her. I'll grab her from one side, to grab her from the other. But Siori probably doesn't weigh that much. Just fling her backwards.
Right.
What could you try to our friend Siori?
No, let me give Mr. Plug his nutrients.
Siori, please get away from there. That plug can't talk to you. You're going to cause an outage.
Let go of me. I must keep the nutrients.
If the house blows, I'm done. The glass breaks. Liquid immediately spills over the plug. Well, let's look on the bright side. At least that only gave us a power surge. Still going to be a pain in the ass to deal with later, but... To be fair, this house is kind of old. That probably would happen eventually. Let's look at the bright side. No one can... Bro, just let me calm down. This is great. We're all okay. Everything's fine. The house blows off. I'm done. Well, let's see. MC starts walking to the kitchen. Grabs a cup, gets the eggnog bottle, pours the eggnog into the cup. Then he goes to the refrigerator, grabs a water bottle. Place the water bottle on the table. So, give me that to Siori. My parents just tell me that water helps to wash down the alcohol. Something about carrying the dehydrating effects or whatever, and might have served up quicker. I'm going for a walk, then to clean my yard. I also have to call someone about the electrical box. I feel so flippin' bad for... Oh, before I go, guys, I'm sorry today ended up pretty underwhelming. It certainly didn't end up like how I thought it would. I guess it's just... That's just the trail of me, isn't it? Bro, don't go into depressive spike. It's not Yuri's fault! MC leaves the house. Wait, is it still going? Oh, shit. Okay, I thought the episode would have at least ended by now. Well, I'm gonna leave this one here. If you guys enjoyed, please like, subscribe. See you guys next one. Peace out.